I am extremely interested in how this match turns out, T.
Oh, as am I. That's why we made it happen. Both accustomed to being tag team workers, but you know, I think you've utilized Stephen Lust in some singles matches.
He was a singles guy when he first showed up. We didn't have Broad right away.
Well, Chris
he could have easily been the ace of the Proving Ground for sure, by himself.
I could see that. I could.
But Chris Dozer.
Chris Dozer, former multi-time Triple Crown champion, has had battles, has had wars with Chris Pyro, Jammin' Jack Connor, just to name a couple.
Not your typical wrestler, not the typical look or shape of a wrestler. But the thing is, if anything, he's unique. And honestly, I've watched a lot of RWA, and I should have seen more of him than I have, but honestly, I haven't. So this is really my first exposure, especially to a single Chris Dozer. I'm going to assume that he doesn't take too kindly to that kind of thing.
Nope, absolutely not.
There it is.
That right hand has won championships. You got to watch out. If he connects full on, it's over.
Irish whip. Big splash in the corner. Off the ropes. Clothesline to a supine. Stephen Lust.
He's got that look in his eye.
Ooh, oh,
wow. He's got that boot in his face.
Full force into the face. Weight up in the fireman's carry. Gouging the eyes with the referee not seeing it.
It's all about positioning.
Strike combination by Stephen Lust, followed by a Yakuza kick. And a senton. Kicked out with authority. I like that. So it's almost too often that you see people just raise the shoulder and go right back down. He kicked out with everything he had. Ooh, 2 feet to the face.
You know, there's a lot riding on this. Even if it's a standard singles match with no championship implications, everybody is looking to move up the ladder one way or another. I mean, you're sitting ringside, I'm sitting ringside. This is brand new territory for us, for them. We have a front row seat. Normally, I'm in the back, I'm here, I'm there, I'm everywhere, answering questions, delegating, and a variety of things. So,
one of the things I was told when I accepted this position, almost all the boys came to me in the locker room and said, please do something about our tag team division. These two guys are cornerstones of tag teams here. We just watched two killer tag teams, including your RWA tag team champions. So when you say, even though there aren't any title implications, I got news for you. Both of these men have partners. Both of these men are showing me something. There are always title implications.
Fair enough.
I mean, they also said we need more women wrestlers, but wrestlers were a bunch of horn dogs, so I'll reconsider that eventually. Ooh, a big kick to the face of Chris Dozer. Stephen Lust back on the upper hand and a spine buster! Cover! That was a smart cover. Got a leg, put his weight on the shoulders. I'm starting to understand why this Chris Dozer fellow was so successful.
You know, and I dare to say, not to say he's not the same person, but the Chris Dozer that was Triple Crown champion was a sadistic, ruthless individual. You know, Cipriano brings out a softer side of him, but, you know, don't get me wrong, he's still a killer. You just may not be witnessing it right this second.
Oh! Banged him right in the middle! Two! That's it! I gotta say, Stephen Lust being successful as a singles does not surprise me. But Chris Dozer definitely showed me something with this match.
Even in a losing effort, impressive as you said,